Not quite 1 minute ago, I heard the first thunder today up there over the little canyon where I live. And there's rainstorms reaching this direction from the mountains. Maybe there'll be some more thunder, and maybe I'll be lucky enough to catch it with this little camera. That's how it looks to me. Few drops of water falling down. Late afternoon. In the suburbs of San Diego, California. We got kind of warm today, but it's better now. Some more thunder just now. The camera was off when it started, but I turned it on and caught the end of it. It's still going on. That's an airplane. That noise. Whining and growling across the sky. That's one small plane that's very, very close. It so loud I can't even tell if it's drowning out the cars or if the cars are drowning out the thunder or what. But everything seemed to happen at once. We had some thunder, and then we had a couple of planes, one big one higher up and one small one coming right over here. And pretty soon we'll have another car on the road. Sunday afternoon, just about 5 o'clock, a little bit.
All right, but first you'll need to unlock your device.
No, I don't need you. And that's how it is here. I hung my underpants out to dry this afternoon after washing them, even though it's Sunday. And my mama used to say that she didn't want to do laundry on the Sabbath. Yeah. And then, of course, you know me, ornery old me, I'd say something like, well, for Jesus, the Sabbath was Saturday. And she'd say, well, for my mother, the Sabbath was Sunday, and she didn't want to do laundry on Sunday. And her mother didn't want to do laundry either. It was a long time ago when all those things had happened. Yeah, here I am talking about what my grandmother's mother did. Waiting for some more thunder to see if any will come. Still got some little drops on the pool over there. That big car going by on the road, that's one way to know where I am. The road. Mostly water. Some Bombay gin. And a couple drops of, I forget the brand name of the dry vermouth. Well, a lot of water. Some frozen water. Yeah. Got warm today again. It's been getting warm here, like most of the places in the Northern Hemisphere. I was exchanging a couple emails with some old family friend that I know from years ago when we were kids. And then she got married, so I know her husband too. They live in Australia. And they call it Oz. And it's winter down there for them. Down there. Up here it's summer, and we're getting just a little taste of the monsoon. Not much, just a little fringe. My cousins in Arizona get a lot more than we do. Every summer they get it on and off and on and off and on and on and on and off. But we just get it spitting around the edges. Although sometimes in the mountains here, east of me, I'm close to the city. I'm about 12 miles from the coast, from the ocean. But in the mountains, about 50 miles from the ocean, there'll be more thunderstorms and flash floods. Sometimes they crash down into the desert and move the dry rivers into flooding mess. Sometimes. It reminds me when one of the first or second times I went to a meeting in Sonora, in the Mexican state of Sonora, a meeting of writers there in the beginning of June. And we went out to eat at a place I'd looked up in a book, and it was all outdoors. We were all sitting outdoors. There was hardly anything indoors there. Some of the kitchen was covered, but everything else was an old house that just the outer walls were left. And we were sitting in these spaces where there had been rooms, but now there was no ceiling. And I said to the woman who was helping us pick our food and who brought it to us and all that, the server, the waitress, I said to her, when it rains here, don't you have problems? And she smiled and said, it has not rained here, Señor, for 10 years. Well, it's rained once or twice since then. I couldn't go to the year where it actually rained in the city of Hermosillo, in the state of Sonora. No, I had to, already had a plan to go on a little trip with my mom, and I didn't want to back out of that. So I didn't go to Hermosillo the 1 year it rained there. That would have been my third or fourth year of going to the meetings. I made some videos of the meetings and my time there. You can either find them on my YouTube channel or on my Vimeo channel or wherever else I copied it to later. But that's much too selfish for me to talk about that. It's been a lucky summer for me. The temperature never got above 100, and usually 90 was the worst. But of course, summer's not over yet, and sometimes here our worst summers are in September and October. So we shall see how it goes. A lot of evening traffic here in the sky and on the road next door to me. And as I'm about to show you, it's still raining a little bit here. You might be able to hear the pitter-patter of the drops. And there's not enough rain to make the patio really wet yet, just a little damp. So far, the big show is... Oh, get that guy out of there. So far, the big show is the sound of the water hitting the water. Hitting the roof, hitting the trees. Yeah. That is not thunder. That is an airplane. And then there is a car. But they're both so noisy that I think I'm hearing thunder. But I cannot say as I really am, and it's certainly not as loud as the raindrops falling on the cement pond. No, it isn't. And even that is noisier, the car going by that way. Look, there's my underwear. Well, as you can see, it's rained a little bit more. Basically, it's just kept on dripping for an hour or two. So it's not really raining much heavier, it's just that it keeps on raining. Little sprinkly drops everywhere. So, I think that it is safe to say that things are getting a little wet around here. And I look over at my phone and see that it's not quite 6 o'clock. There's still another hour and a half before the sun goes down, and it'll be dark in about 2 hours. The days when the sun set at 8 o'clock are gone now.